The Metropolitan Toronto Police Force is very committed in dealing with the issue of hate crime. Hate crime is something that many of you had not heard about until recently. It seems like every day as we read our newspapers or watch the television, we see something dealing with the issue of hate crime. Many of these incidents in the past have been in faraway countries and have not affected us here. But today, unfortunately, has become an everyday occurrence in our schools. The Metropolitan Toronto Police Force is very happy that we're able to work cooperatively with the school boards in Metropolitan Toronto in attempting to eradicate this very, very serious problem.
In a world with a cultural difference that should be appreciated, we face a lot of hostility. We have forgotten how to tolerate each other. We fight, we attack, we ridicule. Hostility takes on a new meaning when we can't even share the same cafeteria. We have somehow forgotten that each culture has something to offer to society. Spiritual, emotional, and physical differences are part of a changing, growing world. How then can we repair the damage already in progress? We can begin by remembering that we all have the same pressures, disappointments, heartbreaks, and challenges. Have you ever been threatened because you speak differently? Has someone ever held a knife to your throat because they don't like the way you look? None of these things can be tolerated. This presentation, Making Spaces, Changing Places, reflects the theme, Making Spaces for Others, both psychologically and physically. While changing places is giving a sense of how others experience our world and are essential for all mankind. The Earth's resources are not expandable, whether we like it or not. We are going to have to share spaces and places together. This presentation has been produced in the hope that it will help increase tolerance and acceptance by the many human cultures sharing space on this planet. Remember, underneath we are all the same.
Music. The only pop we like is soda.
Those rockers don't know what real music is. All they listen to is noise. You can't even understand what those rappers are saying.
Yo, do we listen to that heavy metal crap? Hell no!
The only place pop music should be played is in the elevators.
You call rap music?
No, man.
Well, rap isn't music. Rap is just talking past the stolen music.
Thank you.
Man, women have been nothing but trouble ever since the beginning. That damn Eve.
Men, you can't live with them, but you sure can live without them.
The only place women should be is barefoot and pregnant and tied to the kitchen sink.
Yeah, he's got it.
The problem with men is they don't think with their brains, and what they do think with doesn't work out.
No, wait. See, these women have to understand the only time they'll ever be on top is in the bedroom.
You know, I wonder if that was John Bobbitt's attitude on women.
Snip, snip.
Wow, I can't wait for September. We finally get to go to high school.
Yeah, we're finally growing up now.
And we actually get away from those grades since Echo Brighton.
Oh, you geeks. Just imagine, a couple more months left of high school, and we are off to university. It's so nice to be an adult.
Yeah, we won't be stuck with another bunch of grade nines. Every year we get smaller.
And every year they get lost. Just think about it. We are finally graduating from university this spring.
And I've even got a real job lined up.
You know, it is so great to be grown up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I start my last practice teaching next week. God, not in a high school.
Yep.
I hope they're potty trained.
Jehovah Witnesses, always banging on people's doors.
Yeah, and it's always like Saturday morning, early.
Atheists, why would anyone not believe in God?
Catholics, how can they believe all of that stuff? It's brainwashing. All those Mormons know how to do is make commercials.
Yeah, and babies.
Why do all those born-again Christians have such a holier-than-thou attitude?
Look at those Jews, those funny little hats. They should be able to fold their hats. Those immigrants, they get right off the boat and straight on the welfare.
And how 20 to 30 of them can all live in the same house, especially with those weird food smells stinking up the place. And they're always complaining. If they don't like Canada, they want to get back to their own country. You know, they act like they just sprouted up here. Their grandparents were immigrants too.
And it's not like if they owned this land, they stole it from the native Canadians, you thieves.
Yeah, I tell you, this country would fall apart if us immigrants didn't do all the dirty work.
Over half of the people in Toronto have immigrated here in the last 25 years, anyways, or their parents did.
Man, we're good enough to clean the toilets, but not good enough to live on the same streets. That's ridiculous.
If we all went back to where we came from, this country would be empty.
See ya.
Our parents came here over 25 years ago. With their fingers to the bone just to have what we have today. We didn't expect to live on welfare.
Most of us do work. Those who don't can't find jobs because it's a recession, you know?
When we came here, we had to learn about Canadian history. But now you expect us to learn about Black history too. I mean, we don't have any Italian history, any Afghani history, or any Hispanic history. So why just yours?
It's because you don't know any Black history. That's why you keep on looking at us as pimps and pushers, even when we're doctors and lawyers.
We work hard to learn English, but you just want to keep to yourselves and speak whatever that is.
Man, the thing is, when you guys learn the language, you guys could blend in, but us being Black, now we'll never blend.
No man.
No woman.
No child.
No one.
Is an island.
Entire of itself.
Everyone is a piece of the continent, a part of the main.
Hey, George!
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
hold on, man.
Hey, man. Are we gonna still work on our science project after school?
No problem, but this time, you know, don't forget your stuff, man.
Don't worry about it. I have everything with me. The ACD reports I found in the library. Oh, and that book Mr. Young gave us on the acids. Now listen, I was thinking, for our model, could we use clay or Play-Doh?
Or maybe even Lego.
Hey, that's great.
You know, find me to my locker. I got some blister board and posters that we can all assemble together and stuff.
And for our oral presentation?
Come here.
Hold on a second, okay, Rohan? Hey, Leah, what's up?
What are you doing?
Well, it's just speaking with Rohan there.
Why?
Because we're working on our science project together.
This is lunchtime, George. Don't you think you should have had that done in class?
Come on, Leah. You know it's due next week. You don't want me to get zero, do you?
Your reputation is at stake here, you know.
What do you mean?
Look at him.
Why, what's wrong with him?
Fine, George. It's him or us.
Come on, let's go.
Kirstie, how you doing?
Fine.
Well, I had a chance to look over your transcript, and I see here that you have an 80 in English and an 85 in general math. You know, I strongly advise that you upgrade that math.
Wouldn't that mean night school?
Or summer school.
No way, I'm having that problem with the classes I'm taking now.
Well, I don't want you to close all of your doors yet. You should leave some of those options open. So important for women to remain in math these days. Here, take these university catalogs, look them over, and we'll speak again later.
Red Rover, Red Rover, we call Kirstie over.
Next.
Hi.
Hi. Wayne, right? Okay, by looking over your transcript, I see here you have an 80 in English and an 85 in general math. Will you be taking a business math or a technical math course in the fall?
Well, actually, I was planning on...
Well, what were you thinking of doing in the future?
I'm planning on becoming an engineer.
Oh. Well, under the circumstances, I think you should be a bit more realistic. There's some excellent engineering technician courses at a community college. You might get into one of those. Here, take these college catalogs, look them over, and we'll speak again later.
Red Rover, Red Rover, we call Red Rover.
Is out. Add faster. Now go. shit!
Why is it when space gets tight, we all get uptight?
This has got to be the slowest elevator in the entire world.
Ding! Zoop! Zoop! Ding!
Oh my God, it's a skinhead! What's her problem? He's got a cane, and he's wearing those boots. Oh my God, he's gonna beat me up!
She keeps looking at me like I'm gonna attack her or something. I gotta get out of here! He's after me. Where can I hide?
Do I smell or what?
Jonathan?
I've eaten my last my morning anything. Just don't hurt me.
Oh, relax, lady. He could have been a Nazi with the Klan or something. I'm lucky to get out of there with my wife.
I wonder what she's on. She's probably just another one of those junkies.
Zoop. Ding.
Oh my God, it's another one of those immigrants.
Why is he looking at me that way? Did I spill something?
I wonder what he's looking for. I hope it's not a bomb. These guys like to blow things up.
Does he think I'm a terrorist or something? Look at him. He looks like he's gonna go start a riot somewhere.
What if he hijacks this elevator? Where am I gonna hide?
Is he looking for a place to hide my body after he kills me? Jeez, this country's violent.
Ding! Zip.
Those immigrants, they're in the banks, they're in the post office, they're everywhere!
Thank God he left. He probably went to get his gang.
Hola, ¿me puedes enseñar el camino?
También, es que vous pourriez me montrer le chemin?
Buongiorno, mi insegni la strada giusta?
Guten Tag, können Sie mir den Weg zeigen, bitte?
Alla pure mente carta in lima. Grazie per la domanda grande. Carolina ha dato un tale nome. Ciao, anche per lui non ci vuole un tale nome.
La cosa mi passa una seconda. Non ti chiamo, se ne prego spazzurro. Salam, alas, mamma, rarahmini. Marhaba, aspettate anche un mistero.
Bien. Vamos a mandar a Paradi, ¿sí?
Hola, ¿me puedes enseñar el camino?
Sí, es que vos por bien me monté el camino.
Buongiorno, ¿me enseñas la strada giusta?
Guten Tag, ¿cómo se me da un pez, sabe, Peter?
Vale, pura vende carta en Lima.
Grande, pura Fernanda Grande.
Salud, nada, con tanto no. Chào, anh có thể đi làm chuyến đường mình tốt không?
Là tôi đi một bác sĩ trên đá. Một chút sáng lên trong một trò chơi của tôi không? Và làm sao em mà nói là mình mất khả bạc ở trong tất cả anh tôi đi một trò
chơi? Vâng, em muốn xin mong bảo là phá ra bị sợ lý.
Hola, me puedes enseñar el camino?
Vâng.
About the future.
I feel like no one really understands me, including me.
Will I ever be successful at anything?
Whenever things go wrong, I'm sure it's all my fault.
I look around the world, and it's in such a mess, everything just seems hopeless.
No one likes me. I don't even like myself either.
I have nobody to talk to.
Everyone would just laugh if they knew how I really felt.
If I can't be the best, it's not worth trying.
My parents think I'm a failure. Maybe they're right.
What does all this school stuff have to do with reality anyway?
I wonder if anyone will ever really love me.
No one cares what happens to me. So why bother?
I'm afraid of so many things. Why do people judge me as being what I'm not?
When I'm hurt, why isn't anybody there to comfort me?
Sometimes when things are a day worse, I wonder if they'll ever get better.
What's the use of growing up when there's nothing worth living for?
Bye.